Hey, what's going on, guys? In this video, Wilson Combat Ultralight Carry Compact final thoughts. All right, 5.5 years of carrying this gun right here. I want to just do this video because a lot of people are asking me, do I even still own this? And what am I carrying? Do I even carry this gun anymore? The other side of the coin of that is people are tired of seeing revolver videos from me. hey, year 2023 is the year of the revolver for my channel, and I got even more revolvers to talk about and show you. But I guess there are a lot of people, I don't know if it's a lot, they're kind of like, can't you show something else? You know, enough with the revolvers. If you've seen one revolver, we've seen them all. So, I don't know, let me think this through. I really wanted to continue on this entire year just doing revolvers. And there's a reason why the Pug Nose is on in this video too. So in a couple of minutes, we'll talk about that. But anyways, last year, I don't think I even gave you an update, you guys, an update on my Wilson. I was still carrying it last year, all right, inside the waistband. And then this year, 2023, I just dived right into revolvers. So I just wasn't thinking about this. So let's just quickly kind of go through this and talk about this Wilson Combat Ultralight Carry Compact. 5.5 years carrying the same gun, yes. This gun has served me very, very, very well. And I can't say enough good about it. I don't even know if you can see the wear on this. All the armor tough is coming off of it. The scratches. It's always tough to see it. But anyways, this gun has done a lot, you know, with me. I've put not a ton of rounds through it, but enough, okay? The Wilson Combat Hackathorn Special that I own, that one has had a lot of rounds through it with not one single malfunction ever. So we can talk about the Hackathorn Special sometime this year, I guess, if you want to look at it again. But the Ultralight Carry Compact, now, it did have 3 malfunctions that were related to ammunition, jacketed hollow points. Other than that, the thing runs flawlessly with full metal jacket, ball ammo, to this specific round right here, which was my carry load, the Barnes Bullet Pinnacle ammo from Wilson. So that stuff works very good in here. And all I can say is it's a very reliable handgun, and I would carry it probably forever. However, the reason why I'm doing this video is because I've decided to retire this 1911 this year. I might go back to it in 2024, but I've decided to retire it and not carry this gun anymore. That might be shocking, but it's because 2023 is the year of the revolver. I have been shooting so many different revolvers this year, like constantly at the range. I no longer bring, I still bring out some of my autos, but for the most part, I've been shooting revolvers. So I was thinking to myself, you know, I'm shooting a ton of revolvers now. I'm not really shooting, you know, these pistols or 1911s or anything like that. It makes sense to start carrying a revolver religiously. Hence why the Pug Nose is here. I started carrying the Pug Nose again about 3 weeks ago, and man, do I miss this revolver. This revolver right here has got to be one of the most fired shot, whatever you want to call it, revolvers in my collection, stable, whatever you want to call it. A lot of rounds have been put through this specific revolver, and so many rounds have been put through this that this has been sent back to Smith & Wesson for repairs. So this thing has been through the ringer, and I love this thing. I know a lot of people don't like Smith revolvers, you know, blah, 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 but I really like the Pug Nose, and the thing works out. So I have been carrying this, believe it or not, again, and I've had this Pug Nose for many years. You know, this is the one of the longest standing revolvers, well, I shouldn't say that, in my stable, but this is one of the ones I've carried the most besides my J-frame, the 340 PD. The 340 PD does get carried a lot, and that one definitely is showing a lot of wear. It doesn't look pretty anymore, but the thing works, and I rely upon it. But yeah, I've been carrying the Pug Nose over the last 3 weeks. Not this one, and so I've decided to retire the Ultralight Carry Compact and put it away in one of my safes, and for maybe in the future I'll start carrying it again. I probably will. So I'm not carrying a 1911 anymore, going back to the revolver full-time, which is fine. So that's the update. I mean, all I can say is if you're looking for a 1911 for serious use, And I think the majority of people out there are not. But if you are, of course, take a look at Wilson Combat. They put out some quality 1911s and other guns. Like, they have other lines of firearms that are pretty interesting. But if you're looking specifically for a 1911, just go to Wilson. Now, yes, I understand their base pricing in 2023 is astronomical. It is a lot. A couple of years, maybe like 10 years ago, the base price was not this high. But back 10 years ago, it was pretty high. So now it's like, wow, we're hitting over $4,000, which, that's a lot for one handgun. But if you get one, you're in good hands. All right, you're going to be in good hands. And carry the thing if you get one. Don't worry about scratching it and the finish wearing off. Get out to that range, start training and practicing with your Wilson Combat, put it through the ringer. Okay, and again, don't worry about if you're in a quote-unquote good shoot. This gun's going to go into an evidence locker. It's going to get confiscated, and you might not ever see it again. Who cares about that? If you're in a good shoot, and you're still alive, and your loved ones are still alive, and innocents are still alive because you utilized a Wilson Combat, then so be it. You're not going to be thinking about getting this gun back. Trust me on this. Trust me on this. After a good shoot, you're not going to be thinking about guns. And if you never get it back, then so be it. You cashed in on your insurance policy. You put the claim through and the claim was approved. You're alive. So that's all you should care about, not about getting your gun back. So I'm just throwing that out there. Because a lot of people are always come to, hey, you got that court revolver. If you carry that court revolver and it gets confiscated in a good shoot, you're not going to feel so good. Why would you... Again, why are you thinking about that cost when its main goal is to defend your life? And if the time comes, God forbid, then it comes. Like I said, you cash in, you file the claim, and your claim gets approved. You're cashing in on your insurance policy. So you just have to look at it that way. Do you have to have a court revolver? Do you have to have a Wilson comp? No. No. Get what is, that you're comfortable with. Get a 1911 that you're comfortable with. You don't have to spend this much money on this or that. Just get something that you're going to get out there and train and practice with. That's all. So I'm going to stop talking about that. All I will say is this gun is phenomenal, but it is being retired. And it's been a very good 5.5 years. The holster that I use with this is a Milt Sparks. It doesn't look pretty anymore, but it still works. After being used 5.5 years straight. Awesome. If you want a quality holster, get Milt Sparks. I mean, the proof is in the pudding, right? So I think that's all I have to say. And to end the video, some people are like, hey, can you show more, like, I don't know, some people say, show some more 1911s, show some more all the different handguns. I'm not going to be going into my AR-15s or, the Tommy Bilt guns or all that other stuff just because that's what kind of messed up my channel back earlier in the year. Also, my range footage, I can't get that uploaded because there's something wrong with what I was doing, and it messed my channel up. So I will work on range footage because I know that I can upload that some way somehow without the video being pulled and reviewed. But I'm not going to be showing any more AR-15s, suppressors, like short-barreled rifles, and just for now, because it always screws up my channel. I don't know. Because someone had filed, I guess, reported a couple of these videos, that's why they're always looking for them. Whatever. I'll show some more guns. I have a bunch of Smith & Wesson third generation autos I can show you. Those are kind of interesting. I mean, they're not like anything spectacular or rare. They're just old, Smith autos from back in the day. I do have one that's very interesting. The Target pistol. That's very cool from back in the day. So, maybe we'll do a video on that one sometime. I don't know. I'll have to figure it out. But, we can do some more videos on handguns. That's what started this channel. I guess I'm just gonna stick to that, and hopefully I can stay around. So that's all I wanted to really talk about. The final update on this Wilson Combat is that it's always worked. I have no qualms with it. You know, it's a great carry gun, but most people aren't going to want to carry cocked and locked the 1911. But for me, I love 1911s, and you know, once you carry a Wilson, I can't really go backwards. Maybe I could, but I really like Wilson Combats. Am I going to get any more? No, I'm not going to. Again, the base price of these guns in 2023 are very high, so I can understand why people shy away from them. But 15 years ago or so, you know, they were a little bit lower. So I don't know. You're gonna have to decide if that's something you want to spend money on. But I've always been a Wilson Combat fan since 1998 when I bought one of their, I think it was called the 1996 A1. It was used at a gun shop. And to be quite honest with you, it was not that great of a 1911. But that was Wilson Combat's first branded 1911. And it wasn't good. I'll tell you right now, I was not impressed with that 1911, and I traded it away for something else. I don't know what. But when they came out with their CQB, that's when they hit their mark. And I've always liked Wilson Combat since. So, all right, guys, leave some comments below. Let me know what you think. And as always, stay safe and check 360 often. Later.